okay.
It happens, you get it.
Doesn't happen, sugar. I know, I can.
So we got, I distributed the final exam questions, there's like two. Homework 3 and 4, already assigned, extra, extra credit. Problem set, posted with the solutions if you're interested. Deliverable 3 will be due on final exam day, but I will take late submissions all the way up till 10:30 on Thursday, December 7th, which is my last day. Deliverable 3, cover page clip, memos, stapled together, in color, signed off by me. Homework 3 and 4, cover page, stapled together, please. Stock portfolio, have the memo, and then have the memo stapled to the Excel spreadsheets, and if you haven't done so yet, come see me so I can check off everything and make sure that the Excel spreadsheet looks good. The extra extra problem set, if you want to submit it, the movie review, if you want to submit it, and then give me your resume and your business card and staple the business card to the upper left corner of your resume, and then I'll collect it. If you don't want me to market you, then don't give me the resume, okay? Because I'm going to start giving them to headhunters and other people. What else? Deliverable 2 is due Thursday, November 30th at 1:05, okay? And then I did this last semester, and it was pretty fun, and I think I'm going to do it again this semester. Is on Thursday, December 7th at 2, you're invited to come to the Metro, which is right across from Whole Foods in the parking lot, and there's plenty of parking. You're invited for burger, my little burger, plus soft drinks, okay, unless you're over 21, then I'll buy you beer. This is a pretty fun thing, so I'm going to have my other section, and I'll also have my investments class, and a lot of those guys are graduating, and I won't see them probably next semester because they'll be seniors, and you know how seniors are, they just check out, basically, okay? So your final is Section 1 final Thursday, December 7th at 8 a.m. Section 2, Tuesday, December 6th at 10:30. Your presentations, I have everybody up here. If you don't have a spot, put your spot up. Make sure that when you do the presentations next week, you come in business attire and that you print out the PowerPoint presentation black and white, in black and white, one slide per page, so that I can make the edits while you're doing the presentation and then give them back to you, okay? And then all of it, and then work with me leading up to the final into next week so that we can get those PowerPoint presentations, you know, all cleaned up so that you can print them in color and bind them and use them for internships and jobs. For the PowerPoint presentation, again, I want to audit and sign off on them. They need to be professionally bound through the print shop, and I'll call them today, make sure they have the materials for you. Again, it needs to be in color, one slide per page, the black plastic coated wire bindings, and again, I have examples up there if you want to see what they look like, a clear cover and a black back. Okay, any questions on that? And make sure that you, reference all of these references in the back of your PowerPoint presentation. It's really important. We're not going to do the market updates. We're going to go right into the financial ratio analysis. So what the last class did, which was really cool, is they went up on the Mergent or Morningstar or S&P or whatever sources, most of them use Mergent. And they started pulling down the financial ratios and putting the financial ratios up on the board. And then once we do the financial ratios, we'll fill out the financial ratio analysis. We'll come up with the, we'll set the conditions, we'll come up with the overall financial condition, and then we're basically done. Okay, and I'll stick around and look at your memos or whatever you want to do, eat pie with you, whatever you guys want. So the first step in the process that I need, and you can get this on Mergent, if you go up to the, type in JP Morgan and go to the JP Morgan site through Mergent and you go to competitors, it's going to give you the assets. Okay, and I need the assets for JP Morgan, B of A, Wells Fargo, Citigroup, and Goldman Sachs. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to use the assets as the weighting factors to calculate the weighted averages, which would be the peer group. So kick on your computers, go to Mergent, go to S&P, maybe even start pulling up some of the industry pages because we're going to have to do that. So I need full participation on this, okay? So if you can go up to Mergent and go into JP Morgan, go into competitors, get me the assets, go up into these other companies and start pulling off the return on equity. I need return on equity for these five banks. I need return on assets. I need the net interest margin, the asset turnover, the debt to equity ratio, the PE multiple. You're going to need to calculate through your revenue growth, and you're going to need to calculate through your stock price appreciation. Okay? So if you can work on that for me and get me that data, start populating these things, that would be great. So can you give me the asset values?
Total assets, $2.49 trillion.
For JP Morgan? Okay. $2.49.
Bank of America is $2.187 trillion.
1.819, right. And then how much is Wells Fargo?
$1.9 trillion.
And how much is Citi?
1.79. 1.8.
And then how much is Goldman Sachs? What's the asset values for Goldman Sachs?
7.860 billion.
So basically 900 billion. Mm-hmm. So can you add these up for me and give me the total asset value for the top five banks?
Do you want 2016 or 2017?
It doesn't matter.
Is that 2017?
Actually, this is close enough. This is good. Where did you get?
Mergent.
Mergent, and was it 12-16, or what was the date on that?
It doesn't say.
It doesn't matter because asset sizes are relatively constant. It's really a scaling factor. And I know that these are roughly correct.
What's the question?
Can you add them up?
9.28.
So 9.3. And then can you take the 2.49 and divide it by the 9.3 to give me the percentage? So what we're going to create is the weighting factors. We're going to calculate the peer group ratios. This
0.27.
Is what is it?
27%.
And then what about B of A as a percentage of the total?
24%.
Okay. And how much is Wells Fargo?
20%.
And how much is Citi?
19%.
19. And then how much is GS?
10%.
10?
Yeah.
And then can you add those up and see if it adds up to 100?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So can you give me the return on equity for the top five banks?
9.83 for JP Morgan.
9.83, got it.
That's a the end of 2016.
Yeah, that's cool. Whichever, you can use that for all the financial ratios.
11.15 for Wells Fargo.
11.15, got it. And could the rest of you double check these numbers just to make sure they're correct?
Goldman Sachs is 10.57. Goldman Sachs, 10.57.
Thank you. And what's BMA?
You know what their ticker is?
8.33. As of September 30th, 2017.
Are these, did you check these and make sure they're okay?
I got for Bank of America, I got 6.83.
At 7.56.
Where are you?
On Merge.
Yeah, make sure you use the same time period.
MD 2016.
Okay. So can you double check?
Yeah. That's what it is.
Okay. Give it to me again.
6.83.
Right here?
Yeah. That means Goldman Sachs is what I'm for.
So we're going off 2016 then?
I would use 2016. Because it's the most complete. Because then we'd have to use a rolling four quarter and that becomes too complicated. So let's
Goldman Sachs is actually 9.37. What is that? What are you using?
So you're using year end 2016?
Yeah.
Okay. Now are these correct? Because again, if we mess this up, then the analysis gets messed up.
City's rolling.
I have 6.65 for city.
Yeah.
You want year end of 2016?
Yeah. That's what you guys are giving me, right?
Yeah, that's what I was
going to say. Yeah, year end 2016.
It says on the different sizes
8.5.
Just give me merger. Single source, single time period.
I had 10.27.
For who?
JP Morgan.
Really?
I have
9.83. And then 8.5 for.
This one looks right. That's what we used to have in the last class.
That's what I said.
Okay. So can you double check these both?
Yeah.
See the rest of them?
Goldman Sachs is 8.5.
Mark.
I have 13.36.
For year end 2016 for merger?
Wells Fargo.
Oh, 1 second.
Those are correct. Okay, offered correct. All right. So let's calculate the weighted average. Okay. So we got the weights right here. So calculate these for me, please. 9.83 times 0.27.
2.7.
2.7. 6.83 times 0.24.
1.2.
11.15 times 0.2. 6.65 times 0.19. 8.5 times 0.1.
0.5.
Yeah. And can you add those up for me and get the peer group ROE? Calculating, verifying that these are correct. Again, if they're wrong and they're not calculated correctly, it's going to mess up the analysis.
I got
8.25.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you give me the return on assets? 6.4.
Is it normal that Morningstar has different numbers?
Like they shouldn't be material.
Very slightly different.
Yeah, they're going to be slightly different.
Okay.
Usually you'll pick one source, one time period, and then stick with it. We're just going to, they're close enough. But I wouldn't mix and match. One source, one time period. So what's 1.02 times 0.27?
0.28.
And what's 0.82 times 0.24?
0.2.
What is it?
0.2.
Got it. And 1.18 times 0.2? 0.84 times 0.19?
0.16.
What's 0.86 times 0.1?
0.086.
Got it. Is that correct? Yep, okay. And then can you add those up to get the weighted average in the peer group? ROE. ROA.
0.966.
Okay. And then what about net interest margin? All this should be on that margin page. Under financials, under ratios.
26.69.
26.69, got it. And then can you give me the rest of them?
City is 78.29.
Wells Fargo is 88.99.
This 26.69 is
for City.
I think it's 82.44.
The one I said was for City.
Okay, hold on. Let's start over again.
I'm up on it.
Whoa. That one doesn't. So give it to me again. Give me JP Morgan.
82.44.
Yeah, that looks good. And then what's B of A? Did you say you had for City Offer?
78.29.
Goldman
Sachs is 26.69. Wells Fargo is
88.99.
88.99?
Yeah. Okay. America's 80.49. 80.49. Excellent. So it's 82.44 times 0.27. Let me give you the weighted shares. 82.44 times 0.27.
22.25.
Okay, and 80.49 times 0.24.
19.3.
And 88.99 times 0.2.
17.3.
78.29 times
0.19.
14.8. And 26.69 times 0.1.
2.6. Or just 2.7. Yeah, never mind.
2.67. Can you add those up into the peer group net interest margin? Asset turnover.
Bank of America is 0.04. Goldman Sachs is 0.04 too.
So is JP Morgan.
And then Wells Fargo and Citibank are 0.05.
What's 0.04 times 0.27? And then give you the rest of these. it's basically puts it on again.
Yeah.
Yeah, what do we get for Golden?
104.
Okay.
No.
Wait, but oh four.
It's basically zero, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Basically zero. And then what do we get for debt to equity?
JP Morgan's is one.
Okay.
Goldman Sachs is 2.69.
Okay. What's B of A?
0.81.
Got it. Wells Fargo and Citi.
Wells Fargo 1.6.
What is it?
1.6.
For which one?
Wells Fargo.
Is that correct?
I got 1.28.
1.3?
For 1.28, yeah, 1.3, sorry.
Okay. Anybody else, can you double check that? It should be on that page. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Wells Fargo, yeah.
Is that right? Okay. Well, what do you get for Citi?
1.1.
What is it?
1.1.
Is that right? Can you double check that for me?
0.92.
0.92.
Yeah.
What is it?
0.92.
And 0.92.
Yeah, you're close. You're close. And then what's 1 times 0.27?
0.27.
And then 0.24 times 0.81. Got it. And then 1.28 times 0.2.
0.26.
And then you guys are verifying these numbers for me?
Yeah.
0.92 times 0.19.
0.17.
What is it?
0.07.
And then 2.69 times 0.1. Correct. Was it 0.17?
Yeah.
Okay, got it. And then can you sum them up and give me the peer group debt to equity ratio?
1.16.
1.16?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you moving the camera?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. We want to go over here. Thank you. So can you give me the PE multiples, price to earnings ratios? What is it?
14.3.
Got it. And there's a Leo P of A.
15.3.
15.3. And Wells Fargo.
15.9.
14.9. City.
14.5.
5. And what we have for Goldman Sachs?
14.6.
6. 7.2, 9, and then 0.10. So that's 14.3 times 0.27.
That's 3.86.
Okay, and what's that 15.3 times 0.24?
3.67.
And what's 13.9 times 0.2?
2.78.
And what's 14.5 times 0.9? And 14.6 times 0.1?
1.46.
And can you add those up? Can you give me the weighted average of the peer group PE multiple. Got it. And then this one's gonna be a little tougher. Can you find me, can you go back 3 years and calculate the percentage change in the revenue for me? And then go back 3 years and calculate the price appreciation for the stock price? There's a bunch of other
Sweet.
That was me. Did I pocket call somebody? Yeah, these are just a sampling of the financial ratios. There's some other in the booklets. You need to do at least 2 pages of financial ratio analysis. So you want to probably do the liquidity. Obviously, the ROE, ROA, net interest margin. Those are key, that the equity is key, and then the PE and the revenue and the stock price performance, those are key. So you want to make sure you're doing two pages of the financial ratio analysis.
Yes. To do the stock price, can you just go to Yahoo Finance?
Yeah, just calculate the percentage change. Just make sure you're using, all of them should be the same, just use Yahoo Finance and calculate the percentage change.
Goldman Sachs.
Is this revenue or the stock
revenue? Price? It's down 5.9%.
Okay, can
that's Goldman Sachs.
JP Morgan's down 12%.
Yeah, okay. Is that right? Can everybody check those for me? And then what did you say Goldman was?
Down 5.9.
Can everybody check those numbers for me to make sure they're correct? So we're looking for the percentage change in revenue growth over the last 3 years and the stock price appreciation over the last 3 years.
And then Bank of America is down 1.6%.
Going from 2013 to 16. Mm-hmm. And you're using the annuals?
I'm going to from end of 2014 and end of 2016.
So you're using the quarter? Quarter numbers or annual numbers? You should be using the annual numbers.
Annuals.
Yeah. Okay. Use the annual.
Okay. But okay. It goes from end of 2014 to end of 2016.
1450, that's 2 years.
So 12/31/2013.
Yeah. I'm going to use a year end annual. 2013, 14, 15, 16, and then the year end annual 2016.
Then the bank kind of Goldman Sachs aren't there.
What about you? Double check JP too.
Bank of America. Yeah, Bank of America is up 6.8%.
Okay, you need to double check. Are you calculating those yourself? You know how to calculate a percentage change.
Wells Fargo is up 6.9%.
Okay, got it.
The JPF is still down 12%.
Are you guys verifying these things? They could be making a mistake. Alfred, are you getting the same stuff?
No, I got Bank of America down 8%.
Shouldn't it be basically the same?
It
should be reported.
As reported? Okay.
For all?
Yeah, because those are going to be the final audit. And then reported. pretty straightforward if you, you know, you set this up in Excel.
Yeah.
In a table, you just copy it and paste it over, and then you just replace the ROE for ROA or whatever, and it just kicks it out. Copy, put it in, copy, put it in. It becomes really easy to do. It's a lot quicker than doing it by hand than doing it by hand. Are you guys getting these revenue numbers?
Wait, is total revenue, if it says total revenue net of interest expense, that's not the number we're looking for, right?
That's fine, just as long as it's consistent.
Okay.
Across all the banks in the same time period. Personally, I would rather have just top line revenue.
I can't. I don't know where to look.
Yeah, I can't find top line revenue.
Okay, so the only one you have is basically revenue minus the interest expense? Mm-hmm. Then just use that.
Well, that's as reported. If we standardize, there is revenue.
Yeah, right.
You standardize.
Okay.
Just be consistent in the time period and be consistent.
Okay.
I'd rather have top line revenue without any kind of interest adjustment. Because the more you start messing with the numbers, you start to dilute the accuracy.
Wells Fargo's 6.9%.
And then did you verify BMA and
JP? Yeah, BMA is down 8%. And JP Morgan is down 12% too.
And these are what? Standard?
Yeah, these are standardized.
And these are year end? 2016?
Yes.
And what do we have for Citi?
I have the stock price.
Okay, let's do it.
So JPM 36.8. Bank of America 33.1. Wells Fargo -0.01. It's pretty much the same idea.
What about Citi?
25.3.
Yeah, they got hammered.
And 18.6.
Just need to verify the revenue numbers. Make sure they're personal.
Citigroup's minus 0.0.
guys check this for me?
Why are the numbers so different though?
Because those are annual averages. Those aren't percentage changes over a 3 year. These are average annual compound growth rates. You can take the revenue in year three, divide by the revenue in year zero, the 1/3 minus one times 100, it's going to be the percentage. Okay. So it's the average annual compound growth rate, not the percentage change. So it's 0.01 times 0.27. Two times 0.2. Could have used the 3 year, probably the decimal points wouldn't be as bad. Because this is going to look funny on your chart when you got like three decimal points, right? So you might want to go back and do it just the 3 year change.
Yeah, that's the percent change.
Yeah, that's probably what I would do.
I got negative 0.0034.
Is that correct? So did everybody hear me on this one? We probably want to go back and do the 3 year change because this is not going to look good on your chart. Because you're going to have one decimal point for all the other ones.
0.01 is going to be 1%.
What's this?
Yeah, I don't know. But it
says. Oh, is it 1%?
It says percent and has a list and it says 3 year, then it says 0.02. Like it doesn't say if it's supposed to be a percent or just decimal like that.
Oh, you mean you're saying probably 2%?
Yeah.
It's not 0.02, it's 2%.
I guess. I.
Okay. Why don't you just check it? Well, can't you calculate it? Check it?
Yeah.
You got the revenue numbers, you take
the,
revenue. You get the 2016 divided by 2013, take it to the 1/3 minus 1. Do you want to just do the calculation with the revenue? 3 year percent change?
Yeah.
Can we do this?
Yeah.
You're the analyst, so you have to decide how you want to do it. Yeah, do you already have? Yeah, because Wells Fargo messed up and basically ripped off 5 million people. Okay, and then if you add them all up, it's basically zero. Yeah, that's probably right. Yeah, that is.
24.468.
4, 6, 8. Right. 6, 8, 7. Okay, what are we going to do with this? deal with this one?
I'm just doing the revenue change at the end of 2013.
To 16?
To 16.
Yeah, why don't you just do that?
JP Morgan, I got negative 0.74.
Negative 0.74.
Bank of America, I'm going to get right now.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Wells Fargo, plus 6.9.
Plus 6.9?
Plus 6.9, okay. Yeah. And I'm working on the other one.
Are you guys verifying that for me?
Bank of America's negative 7.9.
That is 0.74?
Yeah.
That's not 7.
No, no, okay.
Then what do you get for Citi?
Citi.
Guys verifying these?
Is this I'm using standardized.
Yeah, but we already did that. That doesn't work. Decimal points. What'd you get? Yeah, it's two. You end up with four decimal points. That just, that's crazy.
What did you just put in as 2%?
Oh, is that what that means? Does it mean 2% or 0.02%? It's too late because we're already calculating. So go ahead and put you.
Goldman's negative 7.7.
Is that correct? Did you calculate to make sure these are correct? Yep. Yep. Okay. Cool. So what's 0.7 or negative 0.74 times 0.27?
-21,998.
Could you make it go prop for
plus 1.5? Also wrong.
7.9 plus times 0.24.
-1.8.
And then 6.9 times 0.2.
1.8.
And then -10.9 times 0.19.
-2.1. Do you want 0.07?
No, just round it. 7.7 times 0.1. If you could add those up, this will come out better. Financial ratios. What I need you to do is feed me the JP Morgan ratios, then the BNA ratios, peer group, and then see if you can find some industry ratios from IBIS or Dun & Bradstreet Hoover's or S&P industry reports. See if you can find these. This is going to be really hard to find. See if you can find some things. So why don't you go ahead? Well, others are looking up the industry ratios. Why don't you yell out and tell me what the financial ratios are for JP Morgan?
9.83.
9.8. You only want to use one decimal point.
One. For ROA.
What is it? Okay, 1.0.
82.44.
82.4.
0.04.
0.
One. 14.3.
3.
-0.74.
-0.7.
36.8.
36.8. Yeah. And what do we have for BNA?
6.83.
6.8.
0.82.
number could we get through debt to equity?
21.
8. And PE multiple for E of A?
15.3.
15.3. What do we get for 3-year revenue growth?
Negative 7.9.
Negative 7.9. And 3-year stock price appreciation?
33.1.
33.1. Got it. And then read off the peer groups for me. Peer group ROE?
8.25.
8.3. And ROA? 0.97. 0. And then net interest margin?
76.9.
And then the peer group for asset turnover?
2.4.
0.4 or 0.4?
0.4.
So 0.4?
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah.
And these are 0.04?
That's right.
0.4.
What do that mix this for?
They're ratios, they're turnovers. They're not percentages, they're turnovers. So the X factors are like multiples. Debt to equity. Peer group.
1.16.
1.2. PE multiple.
14.5.
14.5. 3-year revenue growth. Can you find any industry ratios? This is the hardest part. Calculating the peer group's hard enough. Finding the ratios for the industry is tough. You gotta go to Emergent, you gotta go into the industry section, you gotta go to iBiz World. Into industry, you gotta go to S&P, into industry, and you can go to industry through DMU Hoover. So you gotta go commercial banking.
So
is the industry we're looking for.
So you get an Emergent, where's the industry at?
What is it? Didn't you follow Sarah Vitale?
There's two different versions. Yeah.
One's under company information.
That's right. So you got to go back to the beginning. And an easy way to do it is for the stock price appreciation for the commercial banking industry, you can go to Vanguard or Fidelity or BlackRock. And look up a financial services industry or a commercial bank exchange traded fund. And look at the percentage change over the last 3 years in the index for the share price. That's what we did in the last class. Do you understand, Alfred?
Yeah.
We went up and found a commercial banking exchange traded fund. And looked at the percentage change over a 3-year period in the ETF share price.
So I have to select the industry.
Commercial banking. Don't do investment banking, because that's a narrow sector. We want the broad-based commercial banks.
So banks and credit unions, that's what's...
Yeah, I'll take that. Oh, is it because there's too many people walking?
You said just keep our eyes open.
Yeah. You can use other sources too. You can go to S&P or iBiz or DMV Hoovers. I just need something. And if we get bogged down on this, what I do is I'll just plug it out right there, just until you guys find it. If you can't find it, then you can just plug it out. Yeah.
How did we do the growth again?
Correct me if I'm wrong, we did the standardized revenues for year end 2016, 13 to 16, and we calculated the percentage change. Which I think isn't that the top number for the top?
Yeah.
Top line?
Yeah.
In the financial section gives you the revenue. And then we just calculated the percentage change.
So you want the. Want the revenues for 3 years?
The percentage change in the revenues.
Okay, I think
for
I got
the industry, if you got.
Yeah.
Industry ratios are tough. You gotta go all over the place to try to find it.
I got a 6% change for the year.
For the industry?
Yeah.
How much?
6%.
Excellent. And then can you find an exchange traded fund, like a commercial banking ETF for BlackRock or Vanguard or Fidelity or Schwab or Franklin, Templeton, something like that, to get a proxy? You can just Google it. Type in commercial banking ETF, you'll get probably a list.
Does that have all the commercial banks in it?
Yeah, that's fine.
The ETF? What?
No, it's just some representation of a commercial bank ETF. Something that's going to track the share price appreciation over the last 3 years for that industry segment. God, you're so close. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more to go and we'll be out of here. 7 more to go and we'll be out of here.
This one's 8.59%.
8.5?
Is it year to, oh no, that's.
No, I just need the percentage change between the 3 years.
It's giving the YTD performance. The YTD performance?
Yeah, but if you have the share price current, there should be a stock chart. And if you can find the stock chart, it'll probably go back 5 years at least. You could even do it in Yahoo too. I'd Google it, find an ETF, and then go to Yahoo and then type in the ETF ticker and then click on 5 years, and then you'll have the, and that's all you got to do is go back 3 and calculate the percentage change. No ROE, no ROE.
ROA, like 0.8%.
Okay, got it.
Return on capital. Return on equity is 7.6%.
And then where'd you get that?
I'm getting this off S&P.
Okay.
Standard and Poor's, and then you just go to banking industry, and then there's like a whole analysis.
Okay, so this he got this off the S&P industry. Any others? You should have net interest margin. Is that these are key?
PE, forward price to earnings ratio.
Yeah, perfect.
You just want 2017, right?
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
It's like, I'd say like 14.
Okay. Anybody find an ETF?
Yeah, I found one of those 62.1% change.
What was it?
62.1%.
Really?
It was only like 5 companies.
Oh, yeah, we probably should find a broader representation. Because obviously that's... Anybody find me an ETF? I think you're on to the S&P stuff. I know DB Hoover's has it too. And I've
yeah, I couldn't one. Find it on DB Hoover as well. Because I remember it started from
this. Yeah. Yeah. The industry stuff is the hardest stuff. I mean, the peer group's tough enough to calculate. I'll move on and I'll plug these. And then you're going to have to see if you can go find them. And I do want the ETF. Can you just type in financial, yeah, commercial banking ETF?
Wait, the industry ROAL.
This is good. That's good.
I found a different answer.
What was it?
In 2015, it was 1.04.
No, it's 2015. I'm going to use it.
This one's on 10.
Is it?
Banks, but it's super volatile.
Yeah, go five years. Oh, there it is. Okay, so what's the percentage?
This is the 3 year.
Yeah.
Okay, I got it.
Oh, yeah. We'll just take the low. Yeah.
I got debt to equity 26.
Take out that volatility. What?
Debt to equity?
Yeah.
It's 3.1.
What is it?
3.1.
Okay. That sounds right. Ooh, we're doing good.
Excel. It's
got an asset turnover.
Nice.
Point four.
Point four? Point oh four.
I got point four.
Okay. Anything on net interest margin? What do you think the net interest margin is for the industry?
No,
you'll probably have to do some research and find some others. Well, we'll use that for now. Okay, now that we populated the table, okay, now what we have to do is assign the condition for the individual financial ratios. So this is how you do the analysis, okay? So you're going to look at JP Morgan and you're going to say, oh, look at ROE B of A. ROE is greater than the peer group. ROE is greater than the industry. And then you're going to give it a condition. The way you do it is you give it an excellent condition. If the financial ratio for JP Morgan is well above the peer group, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. You would give it a good if it's above or at the peer group. Close to the peer group, it's at the peer group, or slightly above it. If it's significantly above it, then you give it an excellent. If it's at the peer group, or slightly above it, you're going to give it a good. If it's above the industry, you're going to give it above average. If it's at the industry, you give it an average. If it's below the industry, you give it below average. If it's well below the industry, you give it poor. That's how you do the condition. So what do you want to give JP Morgan for ROE?
Excellent.
Okay. What do you want to give it for return on assets?
Good.
Okay. What do you want to give it for net interest margin? to get it for asset turnover. Well, it's everything's 0.04.
Average.
Well, you're really comparing it. You're really comparing J.P. Morgan to the peer group. That's the most important. Not necessarily the industry. What about debt to equity ratio? This is a trick one. Do you want high debt to equity or low debt to equity?
Low.
Yeah, you want a conservative balance sheet. Okay. Compared to, where's the debt to equity compared to Goldman Sachs? So Goldman Sachs is just, you know, the cowboys, right? They want to lever up the firm and take a bunch of operating risk. Why do they want to lever up and take operating risk? What are they trying to do? They're trying to juice the ROE. So J.P. Morgan has a conservative capital structure, and it looks like it's probably, compared to Goldman, slightly under-leveraged. Does that give them an opportunity to lever up the balance sheet in the future? Yeah. And if they do lever up the balance sheet to their optimal capital structure, what does it do to the return on equity? Makes it go up. Okay, so they have borrowing capacity. So if they want to issue bonds and start lending more aggressively, build their asset base, and juice the ROE, they got debt capacity to be able to do it. Okay. So what do you want to give for debt to equity? You want to give it an excellent? Okay. And what do you want to give for the PE multiple? Ratio. Well, it's pretty close to the peer group, isn't it? We'll give them the benefit of the doubt. And what about revenue growth? Really compared to the peer group of the BMA. Their revenue only went down 0.7%. BMA went down almost 8%. Peer group went down almost 4%. Really? What about stock price appreciation compared to the peer group and B of A?
Excellent.
So what would be your overall financial condition and position of the firm using this set of financial ratios? Basically, what you've done through the financial ratio analysis is to assess the overall financial condition and position of the firm. As you can see, the overall financial condition and position of the J.P. Morgan is good, which means that based on underlying fundamental analysis, the foundation of the firm is good, which then allows you to then apply and go on to conduct the intrinsic valuation methodologies. But then this basically sets the foundation. You know going into the valuation process that the overall financial condition and position of the firm is good. So it basically would justify a premium or a hold, okay, on the company. And you've already made that determination. All right. Any questions on this? Okay. That's all I got. So I would take pictures of this. I'll stick around. Check your memos, take your any deliverables, pick up your deliverables, bring some pie, and do a deviled egg, banana cream pie combo. Yeah, could you turn off the camera? Yes, thank you, I appreciate it.
Yeah, sure.
Where is it?
We're the third.
We're the first group on Twitch.